Hey guys, welcome back to Electrical Car Repair Live. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel, guys. If you have a Dodge Dart, guys, and you're trying to find your fuse boxes, stay with us and we'll explain where your fuse boxes are located. You have one fuse box under the hood and you have two fuse boxes, guys, inside the car, and we'll explain how to get to them and how to locate them. Now, quick introduction, guys. Every car we get at the shop, we make at least 200 videos, including, guys, this Dodge Dart, that generation. Why? Because our mission here at the shop is to save you guys as much money as we can. So please, guys, subscribe to the channel and like the video. Hopefully, guys, you will find the information helpful. If you guys want to save even more money on car parts and tools, check out, guys, the link in the description of the video below, and you can see where you can get parts and tools for super good price and fast shipping as well. So let's go ahead and start on the fuse boxes now. So, first, let me go ahead and open the hood and I'll show you where the major fuse box is located. So we need to go ahead, pop the hood open. Okay, perfect. This is, guys, a Dodge Dart right here. Doesn't matter if you have the SXT, GT. Okay, procedure is all about the same. So, still trying to figure it out. It's right here, guys. Check it out. We open it. So let's support it now, quick. And while we are doing that, I'm going to explain, guys, okay, where the fuse box is located. Check this thing out. This thing next to the car battery, guys, right here, this is your main fuse box, and that's where it's located. Now, how do you guys open that thing? Okay, that is the question. Now, right here you have one clip towards the back, towards the inside of the engine, excuse me, on the left side. Push it in and then pull up the cover, come like that, slide it out. Okay, you have two small clips that go right here. And this is, guys, the main fuse box for that Dodge Dart. Now, what about the other ones, guys? Okay, the other ones, we will take some disassembly and we will explain why. Now, if you guys actually come all the way under the seat, okay, now you're going to have a BCM fuse box, BCM and interior fuse box, two of them. And we will explain where they're located. So, let me grab the light, okay, like that. Perfect. And if I come over here, okay, one of the fuse boxes, guys, okay, it's right there. This is one of them. The other one is the BCM right here. But how we get to it? So stay with us and we'll explain now. For this one, okay, you can access the fuses like that. You can see where they're located. The other thing, guys, okay, you have your knee airbag right here, so be careful that thing not to blow up in your face. So I recommend to have the car battery disconnected at least 1 hour before you're doing any fuse replacements, and be careful because those airbags can kill you. So what we'll do now, guys, okay, the BCM is located behind that cover. We'll show you how to remove the cover and how to get to it now. Let me explain now. First, we're going to remove that cover. We'll get a plastic panel removal too, guys. All the tools and parts that we'll be using in the video, you can find the link in the description of the video below, guys, where we got everything from. So, plastic panel removal too now. Okay, with that thing, the possibility to damage your trim pieces is way less than not using that tool. You have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 clips that attach right here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Perfect. Now, let me show you what else we'll be doing. Okay, we need a 7mm socket. Okay, 7mm socket. And right here now underneath, okay, we have one screw that we need to remove. Perfect. One is out. Okay, let me show you what the screw looks like actually. Okay, this is, guys, the screw. Now, the same thing, guys, okay, we come right here. Okay, give me just a second to situate myself. Okay, one screw right there next to the headlight switch. Okay, and then we have one more here. Perfect, two of them. On this side, one underneath. Now, what I'll be doing, guys, I'll get the clip removal too. We're going to get underneath. Okay, we remove that one. Perfect. Now I need to come on. Okay, let me just actually come right here towards where the key or the start button will be. And we have one more that we need to remove. Perfect. Now you can see that cover is actually hanging there. That's fine. But you can see right here, that's where the fuses and the BCM module are located, right there. If you want, you can go ahead and disconnect all the switches so that thing is not in the way. And I'll explain how to do that now. Okay, right here, there is a thing that we press in, disconnect it. Another clip here. This is for the trunk release, by the way. Okay, just trying to do that now, guys, but it's still holding. Okay, pretty good, so. Okay, headlight switch is disconnected. The interior dimmer switch is disconnected. Trunk release is disconnected. The only thing having here now, okay, some of you will have that, some will not. This is for the climate control, guys. Okay, I'll go ahead and disconnect this one now. So this one again, okay, let me just show you better. On this side, there is a tube that you press in and you pull it out. Now the only thing holding here is the release, okay, for the cable, for the opening and closing the hood. Okay, and if you want, you can go ahead and open, remove that one, but like that, we have plenty of room now, guys. So if you want to actually release the hood cable, you just press in here, okay, and then you slide it out. Okay, and this cover comes out completely, guys, so it's not in the way anymore. And the BCM and the fuses are located right there. So the fuses, guys, that we wanted to show within the other interior fuse box is this one right here. You can see this is the BCM and this is the fuse box right there, guys. That's how you access it, otherwise it's practically impossible. Now we don't have to disconnect all the wires, but we did, so we can show you with a great detail where everything is located. But that's it, guys, right here. So hopefully, guys, the video will be helpful to any of you trying to figure out where your fuse boxes are located and how to replace a fuse. We'll have a video for every single fuse on this car, so if something doesn't work, check out the channel, guys. Hopefully the video will be helpful, guys. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to your channel for more videos, and see you guys next time.